clear, boss.
You came to Ireland to make peace. What kind of peace is made with drastic military measures? Bullets in their bodies and grenades in their faces. Is that a way to stop bloodshed?
Helen, control yourself. You're talking nonsense.
Is it nonsense to think that you can mow down the young men of two countries and not leave a hatred that'll last a thousand years? Why don't you treat them like human beings? Can't you see what war will mean? Can't you see?
Taken the West from me. You have taken what is before me and what is behind me. You have taken the moon. You have taken the sun from me. And my fear is great. You have taken God.
You're trying to save necks, including your own. And I'm trying to save the country. You're for peaceful resistance, as you call it. I'm for Ireland.
I sometimes wonder whether your real sympathies aren't lying with the authorities.
You'll apologize for that.
I'll apologize for nothing.
You're a stubborn man, Mike. You think that violence and courage are the same thing, but they're not. A word is often more powerful than a blow.
Words, words, words. A mask for a coward to hide behind.
Is it true, what Michael just told me?
What did he tell you?
That this might be the last ambush. Let's talk of a treaty.
Treaty? The talk of traitors. Willing to sell Ireland out to the enemy. There'll be no treaty. No treaty until we get what we've been fighting for. We'll keep the flames crackling till we've killed every traitor on Irish soil.
Listen, we are no mercenaries. We attack property, not people. Fascists and government's agents are the only ones who attack the public. British democracy is based on more blood, terror, and exploitation than any empire in history. As a brutal police force whose crimes against the people the media will not report, we have started to fight back, and the war will be won by the organized working class with bombs.
Not in my library, pal.
Possibly not. Angry Brigade, 1970. Another?
Thanks.
Remember January 12th, 1971, October 30th, 71, February the 3rd, 72, and so on? No revolution was ever won without violence. We are still alive and growing. Fascism and oppression will be smashed, embassies, hired guns, murderers, judges, property. Now, do you know the difference between those two statements?
No.
10 years. The first was received by the national press 10 years ago from the Angry Brigade. The second arrived last Monday, the day before the bombing at Aldershot.
Snow is general all over Ireland, falling on every part of the dark central plain, on the treeless hills, softly upon the Bog of Allen, and farther westward, softly falling into the dark, mutinous Shannon waves. One by one, we're all becoming shades. Better to pass boldly into that other world in the full glory of some passion than fade and wither dismally with age. How long you locked away in your heart the image of your lover's eyes when he told you that he didn't wish to live. I've never felt that way myself towards any woman, but I know that such a feeling must be love. Think of all those who ever were, back to the start of time. And me, transient as they, flickering out as well into their grey world. Like everything around me, this solid world itself, which they reared and lived in, is dwindling and dissolving. Snow is falling. Falling in that lonely churchyard where Michael Fury lies buried. Falling faintly through the universe and faintly falling, like the descent of their last end, upon all the living and the dead.
Thank you.
Drop the guns! One of you, back in! Bring out the other one! You, face down!
Sing best was the rising of the moon. Well, sure, I used to sing it myself too, though there was a bit of treason in it. I suppose there was a bit of treason in us all.
There is a day-to-day presence of the British Army, which people object to. The level of repression varies from area to area and is greatest in the Catholic city ghettos. But the major problem you see is that you can't get out of the violent situation by wishful thinking and praying. Not that I disregard anyone's belief in prayer, but you can only get out of it by understanding how you got into it. Got into it through a process of history and political developments, and there is a political way out of it. The problem on the ground is that where you're working with people who, particularly in the Catholic ghettos, have unemployment levels as high as 40%, they are not armed with a rational understanding of why they are poor, why they are oppressed, why they get put in prison, why they get the brunt of British Army repression every day. And they're not rationally armed with the means to politically organize to overcome that. And therefore they, which is a perfectly natural thing to them, they fight against it with the weapons.
Okay. In the old smoke by the river, right well known to you and me. And one word more for signal talking, whistle up the marching tune. With your pikes upon your shoulders at the rising of the moon.
At the rising of the moon, at the rising of the moon. With your pike upon your shoulder at the rising of the moon.
So you thought I forgot the old days?
Not so old, Michael. I remember you down by the glen side with the shamrocks in your hat and you drilling with the boy.
Me pension, woman, me pension.
I'll be going home now, Michael. I'll keep the bed warm for you.
Hold on.
The box is... At the rising of the moon, at the rising of the moon, with your pike upon your shoulder, at the rising of the moon.
Well, they fought for poor old Ireland, and full bitter was their fate.
Oh, £500 reward. £500. I wonder now, am I as great a fool as I think I am?
In manhood's burning noon, who would follow in their footsteps at the rising of the moon? At the rising of the moon, at the rising of the moon, at the rising.